Hello, this video is for COM2450. I'm going to be talking about graphs, and particularly social graphs. If you've read my blog post, so right here, I'm going to analyze my own Facebook social graph. As you can see, when you import the graph, the nodes are ordered randomly, and when you apply a graph forcing algorithm, the nodes are forced apart and clustered into sections which make most sense. In this particular example, my high school friends drift towards the bottom and my college friends drift towards the top. There's other minor clusters and there are some strong connecting components. For the rest of this video, I'm going to take this very boring black and white graph and make it look pretty and useful. The first thing I'm going to do is color it by degree or mutual friends, and then make the nodes which are more central to my social graph larger to expose them, and then I'm going to proceed to run another forcing algorithm to make sure the change in sides doesn't affect the overall layout. Now that I have names on my graph, the next thing I'm going to do is partition my graphs based on modularity, or separate them into distinct social groups. Now I've colored my groups a little bit more brightly, and you can see the green being my college friends, the blue being most of my high school friends, and the red being the rest of my friends from my hometown. Now what I'm going to do is add a filter that filters my nodes by the number of mutual friends I have with those nodes. And as you can see, as I modify the filters, certain weird sections of the nodes start disappearing. This behavior is pretty strange, and it shows that I have a lot of mutual friends with my friends back in my high school, but not so many tight connections with my friends in here in college. Now I'm going to generate my final beautiful clustered social graph, and I'm going to put names on them, and that's it. Thank you for watching.